And we're back to start off the second campaign of Richard III, Columbia Games Richard III. Sitting over on the Lancastrian side now, and although their board position is unenviable, they're now the pretender. Their hand is fantastic. Look at all these fours. That's really going to allow us to get a large force back on the continent. Well, I suppose this isn't the continent, is it? This is the British Isles. So I'm thinking of Buckingham kind of leading the way here. Although we also need to get these moved on as well. But we could bring him in Kent or down there. I can't quite read that one, but right in Wales here. So that is a good question. Kent is awfully isolated. If we wanted to make a push in that general direction, that's certainly something we could do. But it feels much safer to go on that side of things instead. I think we need to be very defensive this turn, try to get as much of a board presence up as possible. And we're going to, I think, be able to do that pretty well. So we're going to have two sea moves to get from France to somewhere, because this is a major port to another major port. And we could either put them all in one place or we could split them up. I think we probably want to split them up to try to utilize some of the switching of the nobles options, because we haven't seen that work successfully yet. Our events are not terribly useful, I don't think. I'm not sure muster is going to do as much good. And surprise, considering we're playing a more defensive game, that might help us run away in some sort of situation. But I haven't really got a good handle on the strategies on this one yet. So I'm just kind of doing what I can. So yeah, I think starting off strong with a four is going to be good. And then we'll see the Lancastrian side of things. I'm looking forward to playing a game after this that doesn't involve me switching sides of the table. So let's move on over. The Yorkist hand, by no means bad, but not quite as good as our Lancastrian counterpart. Plague seems to be the most powerful event card I've seen. That could certainly finish off a group that managed to get away. So yeah, for us, I mean, we're already in the winning position. We can try and go for the killing blow, or we can just kind of weather the storm. It's a decent question. I'm wondering about the Welsh blocks. Nope, those are Pembroke over there is set. So where do we think they're going to go? Well, they're probably going to come to the north. Although it's possible they might land something in Cornwall and try to get us from two fronts, I suppose. So I think for us, we need to get these guys back in somewhere. And then who do we want to get on the board? Let's see. This is in the Irish Sea. Can't come around that way. We want to keep control of London. We found out that that's important. The churches are also quite important. Where is Canterbury? That one I'm not familiar with. Ah, down here in Kent. So yeah, I think we're going to want to recruit him, make sure we have this, because that counts as an extra vote as well. So I mean, might as well play the three, I suppose. Seems as good as anything, really, at this point. So we'll flip them over, three and four. The pretender Lancastrians will go first. So let's just take care of both their moves. I don't think there will be any combat this turn, and then we'll come back. Okay, so things are looking much scarier for the Yorkists. The Lancastrians have brought in a tremendous amount of troops onto the board. We've played a four as well. And I can't tell if, try and get it without the glare here, he is very vulnerable, Kent up here. if this is supposed to be a blue border and thereby passable, or a river and thereby, I assume, not passable. It looks like the blue border starts this way, and kind of like down here, it starts and then ends, but I assume that we can cross that. So that's going to be one of our moves. Here, joining up with Hastings. And then for the other three, I'm thinking of landing here. I don't think we can land in enemy territory. If so, we have a few other options. But if not, then I suppose we could come all the way down to Cornwall down here. This is a little bit exposed. Let's see what our options are. As far as sea moves go. There's land moves, sea moves. To a friendly or vacant coast, so we cannot start a attack. Well, if we do come down to Cornwall, that's a major port, which will give us some extra movement options. So we've used one. I suppose it wouldn't, though, because we'll have that extra, unless we want to leave him behind, although I don't think we do. I think we want to bring him down. Well, if that's the case, then, let's see, one, two, well, we'd have one left. If we moved him here, we'd have one movement point left. One action point, I guess. Whereas if we moved him here, we wouldn't have any, but he'd be in a much better position to actually do something. They're fairly good troops. This group, cluster of four, is quite frightening. They came from France, so we know the French knights are in there, and we know the pretenders are in there as well. Now we have, they outnumber us currently. We're hoping that that's the last four that they have. Of course, the Lancastrians are smiling, knowing that is not the case. So if we come here, we're going to have a tough time of it, I think. We're not going to get any defensive bonuses for anyone there. This is a crown. We will get a defensive bonus. None of these are the king. The Earl March is the king. But he will still get a plus one. He won't get a plus... Yeah. I'm fairly certain that's the case. The senior heir of... I better check that. So if that is the case, I think I will come in. It'll be risky, but... An heir has plus one. A royal heir is also plus one when defending a crown. So, and that will just be the senior most. I think we will do that. Now the question then is, what are the Lancastrians going to do? The Yorkists are playing a three to hope to get the initiative to be able to reinforce York and Rutland and the Irish up here, but it is not to be, because the Lancastrians are playing surprise, which means they can get all four of these blocks over into here. Now, the Yorkists, with this three, can get Warwick over there for reinforcements, although he's the only one that can make it at this point. So we're going to have to think about what we want to do. We could try and strike in a separate direction, hope that these guys last long enough to be able to retreat, or maybe even win the day. I mean, they're fairly high-quality troops here. We don't necessarily know what's in there. Although, look, the Lancastrians know they have a few A's, and they're going to get first strikes. I'm tempted to just begin consolidating a force that we can then later move into certain directions, but Do we want to challenge this, or do we want to go in that sort of direction? We know that most of their heirs are here, so if we can get those killed off, we might be able to finish the game. Whereas we still have two heirs that are off the board yet. So if that's a fight that they want to pick, I think it's a fight worth picking on our end of things. So I am going to try to move Warwick in as reinforcements. And then for the other two, we might want to bring some people off the board, or we might want to do some consolidation. Let's see, what are our options? Where's the Canterbury Church? He's down here in Kent. This doesn't do us a tremendous amount of good. But I do want him on the board to stop any forces from coming around on this end, and also to get us that extra vote when the time comes. So that leaves us with one. We could do a recruitment, or we could do a move. I think we'll do a move to try and get some forces. And I think we'll move Norfolk over here. Now we have a strike force there. So that's going to bring us to a battle. Let me get the sheet out this time. Clear some space. Okay, I'm going to need that dice, aren't I? I will use this to say that the red were attacking. Reserves. There's a lot happening here. Oh, I'm supposed to use two different sheets, I see, for that's just confusing then. Yeah, each player is supposed to have their own sheet, I think, and it's supposed to keep track that way. That's a bit confusing though. I'll just lose track. We'll just do it this way. So Somerset, the French. Prince Edward, surprisingly terrible. And the French, surprisingly good. He should be full strength. Okay, well, the Yorkists certainly don't like the looks of that. But we can't retreat in round one. So the first thing that happens is Somerset goes. Four dice, hits on ones or twos. It's going to be one hit. We'll take it on the Irish. Okay, so that's them gone. Now it's our turns as defenders. He is the senior most heir on the board, and we're fighting at a crown location, so that's going to give him a B4, which is three hits. Probably should have done a charge. Okay, that's him gone. Now him, he does not get the same bonus, so he only hits on a one. He did hit, though. Very surprising. He should have done charge. That wouldn't have been likely. Who do we want to take it on? Prince Edward, I think. All right, and then the Irish. No hits for them. So that's all of them gone. He's gone. And now it's a question of the French. A hit. I don't think we want to do any charges yet. So Richmond will hit the ones or twos. He gets one hit. Take the Irish. And Prince Edward, one hit. Take it on Rutland. Okay. Round two. Warwick comes in. Everyone resets. So do the Lancastrians want to flee? I don't believe that they do. And in fact, Do we want to do a charge? If we don't do a charge, we're going to hit him, and he is the most potent adversary at this point. We could try to flip him, but that would be three dice, and they would all need to be evens, which seems unlikely. But boy, would it seal the battle for us. It's a tough decision. You know what? We're going to try it. We're going to try and convert Warwick. Evens. Nope. Two odds. So that's that wasted. Now it's time for them. Four dice for Warwick. Two hits. Oh, wait. Right, we take them both at the same time. I'm doing it Hammer the Scott style. He hasn't gone yet, so because you failed a Somerset, you take the hit. So that was Warwick. Now it's time for York, and I think this battle is going to be pretty much over at this point. So York gets one hit. And no reason to charge, I don't think. We're very unlikely to hit anyway. No, didn't hit. Irish. One hit. Take it on him. Alright, that's all them gone. He's gone. So the French. We could run away. We probably should at this point. Although we could do a charge with Richmond on Rutland. I think live to fight another day is the way to go. So, and he'll get two as well because he's an A. So we put him up. Now the only downside is they can't all run away together. So one of them is going to have to go somewhere else. And we're here, so there's only two places for them to go. I'm going to put him here, and the other three, well, I can go this way, because that's the way we came in, that's fine. Okay, carefully set these up. They cannot regroup, because they are surrounded, and the idea that they are surrounded is interesting. Now, okay, yeah. Yeah, I was just making sure there were some ones, because we're going to be plaguing that, obviously. So yeah, that's certainly what the Yorkists are going to do. As far as the Lancastrians are concerned, I think playing another four just really hammering, trying to recover before the Yorks can do anything. Of course, they aren't going to be able to. So we plague here, choose one enemy city area, all enemy blocks there lose one step, even if eliminated, and that is absolutely devastating. The French, I'm not sure if they're dead or not, but Prince Edward is, and he's now at a one. I need to see what happens to the French. So that played. Then we have four. On the Lancastrian side, let's see what happens when the French die. Where is that? Death of a noble. I'm going to assume these count as mercenaries. Mercenaries go to their home area face down, except for the Welsh. The Welsh. Okay, so, that's them. Right, now the Lancastrians. Well, let's move on over. Let's see if we can salvage this situation. Probably not. Well, I'd like to bring in the Welsh. Look for a Welsh flag. I would think it would be in Wales. Is this not where Wales is? Gonna have to look at where the Welsh go, I guess. This is not their symbol. It's close, but it is not their symbol. Mercenaries, yeah. I got that they're mercenaries. Recruits. Mercenaries. The Welsh start in the Lancastrian Pool and deploy in any friendly or vacant area of Wales. Okay. How do we identify Wales? Is there something I'm missing? I don't see the border for it necessarily. I'm going to think that this is part of it. In fact, that does say Wales right there. Here we go. Wales, Wales. Very tiny, but it is on the map. So yeah, I'm going to try and reinforce him. Because that is that the last? No. We have two royal heirs left on the Lancastrian side, and then this is game over. So we need to protect him at all cost. So that's one. Rivers, I believe his area is taken up. No. Pull in a friendly or vacant area containing their shield. Some blocks have exceptions, whereas if everything is blocked, then they still have an option, but I don't think normal nobles do. And I am fairly certain that that's the only shield that he has on the board. So what do we have left? Well, not a lot. We have the rebels. Actually, bringing those in is probably good at this point. I think I'll bring them here to try and do something over there. Just kind of have them on their own. So I can't add them to one of our forces. I can bring them in anywhere that's not controlled by either side. You know what? Let's bring them here. And then we can also bring in the Coventry, because now that we put them in first, this should be a legal move. So that is three. And then for four, do we want to just bring the Bombard in there as well? Could bring something in Bristol. Yeah, I think we just need to bring stuff off the board. Because these are both A's, so they should be able to run. Well, they can't do it the first round of combat, though. Oh, where could we go? I guess we can hook up with Buckingham down here. Okay, that'll be our fourth. Muster. I'm thinking of mustering here, getting a large force, and then moving in somewhere. At this point, I'm almost just tempted to just stay put and weather the storm. Our other options are two. So we could bring in Bristol and the Bombard, for example. We'd like to clear this out so we can bring him onto the board. That might be what we do. I think we'll play a muster. Any friendly or vacant areas, so that's fine. So we'll say, think we want to do it in Coventry. So we'll say Coventry. We'll resolve that first because they don't have any events, so this is going to happen first. We'll do Stanley. He can move. Now we could bring in a major force and have more than the four and just take that point, but we can only get four across on this way anyway. We need one more.
We'll get Richmond over here just to get him in some semblance of safety, I think. So that'll be our muster. And then on the other side of things, for the Yorkists, well, their choice is easy. All they have left is twos. Well, we would like to hunt, because we are quite we were very reasonably armed still. I'm thinking of coming in from a couple different directions here. Really pushing them to the side. This is a juicy target, but it's going to get them one less noble, I suppose, but not really going to do much for us, I don't think. And we can't get to here because of these red borders. If we cross them, we have to stop. We do have some... We should bring these guys in, because these are fantastic troops. If we bring them in at a major port, we can bring them in for one. Maybe down here to London. That seems reasonable. I don't see any better place. So let's do that. That's one of our two. And for the second, see this large force here. Its problem is, in order to get across in any direction, it's going to have to split up the forces. Because only three can get across the river. And only two can get down here. And a lot can come up here. I think coming down and around might be our best option. The other option is moving a few of these in. I think we'll do that instead, actually. Let's take this gentleman. Let's add him to this force. Let's move him up to this force here. So we can get four across there. That should do fine. All right. Well, another two for the Lancastrian. Easy choice. Oh, and two for the Lancastrian. Two for York and Lancastrian. That's all they have left. So the pretender goes first. Oh, I'm going to have to go around the table again. Whoa. All right, can we see? Right. Well... how many do we have on the board? Nobles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, because I don't think the heirs count. It's a good number of them. I would like to be able to get rivers on. We can move across here and attack, but they'll be able to come and reinforce, although we could come in here as well. That's going to be a huge battle. One will lose, though, because if we come in here, this is a fantastic force, 4-4, but then we'll bring these in as reinforcements for two, but then they'll bring in four reinforcements down there. That's a fight we can't win. So let's try and corner them in instead. Can we make it there? Well, we can get all four around here. And then we can get three across. So who do we want? Well, we want the rebels. We'll leave him behind, I think. Very vulnerable. Too vulnerable. That leaves us with a paltry force. We can bring two in that way. We just need to survive the first round, although they're going to try a charge on us. We're going to do this. three across, and then we'll bring in knees. One, two. That's our two moves. Now we go around to the other side and do the Yorkist. Well, obviously that's a problem. So we're gonna bring the whole lot over here. That's one move. And then for the second,
I don't think we want to leave London empty, because if we do, it doesn't count as a point for us. Well, we can always move something. Again, we have one card left. Where could we get him? We could get him all the way over here. And I think that's what we want to do, this whole group here. One, two. Okay. Yeah, this is going to be a big one. So the pretender went first. He gets to choose the order of battle. He's going to choose the big boy over there. All right, so we have two reinforcements, which we don't necessarily know their strength. Who came in and attacked? It was the Lancastrians. Okay, and then these troops here. Ah, Stanley, however, is ripe for switching sides. And we can do it twice, because we have Warwick and we have one of these royal heirs. So we were defending. However, the rebels go first. Four dice at twos. No hits. They failed them when they needed them the most. All right. Well, let's see. Let's start with York here on Stanley to try and convert him. We need an even number. That is an odd number. We're going to do the same thing with Warwick. I think we can try to convert him twice in a round. I don't think you have to. I know you get two separate ones from having Warwick and York. But I don't think failing once means that we can't try again. But let's check. Surely that's in combat. Oh, loyalty. Yeah, Warwick and his family have special rules. Treachery rolls 6.9. 6.9, alright. May each attempt one treachery roll per battle if present. Treachery rolls made on a normal battle turn instead of firing or retreating. Choose an enemy block, not in reserve, and roll as many dice as the target's loyalty rating. If all numbers are even, the block defects at current strength. The same block can receive three treachery rolls in one battle. Okay. Such as from... So, yep. That's absolutely legal. Let's try it again. Fingers crossed. Oh, Stanley, you stay steadfast. Oh, that is a problem. And that's the only time we can do that, right? We can't try it again next turn. Not that I know that we would. Yeah, per battle. That's it. Oh, this has gotten disastrous all of a sudden. I'm trying to think if he gets the crown bonus. Because he didn't use it. But I think it's only the senior most heir that gets it. So I don't believe he does. No hits. Should have rolled that for the Irish instead. Nah, they got a hit anyway. Well, we'll take it on the rebels. We'll take it on Coventry. They're more worthless than the rebels. Okay, now these two go. So that's all these, all this. Everyone's engaged. Four dice for Stanley, who unbelievably stayed loyal. That's going to be two hits. And they have to go in Warwick. We're not happy about that. And then three for Coventry. One hit. Which will go in York. So these come in, and this battle got terrifying all of a sudden. We can only retreat two of them per battle round because of the situation.
because of the various borders and such. We can get two of them over to Powell's, to Powies per round. We have to hold out for the fourth round, and then they begin to retreat. We can't try and convert again. I think we're gonna go out with these two. Well, no, the rebels get a shot first, as do the Welsh. So the Lancastrians obviously are not retreating. So let's do rebels first. That's one hit. We'll take it on the Irish. And then the Welsh, four dice, one hit. We'll take it on Warwick because we're leaving him behind. Unfortunately, these two are going to run. And these two will fight to the death. We'll roll Irish first, and that's one hit. Take it on the rebels. And then Warwick, one hit. Which we'll take on Buckingham. So he went, these went, now it's these guys' turn. Let's do Stanley. Yep, that's death. And because it wasn't a charge, I believe they roll over, although it doesn't really matter at this point. So Irish go face down in Ireland, and Warwick, I believe, is out of the game. I will double check that, but I believe he's dead. Died a bit early. All right, and these guys can regroup, although I don't know that they want to. This seems like a fine spot, really. And I think they'll stay there. Oh, there's five of them, though. Let's make sure we set them up correctly. Who do we want where? Let's bring two here. One, don't we? Well, we don't know. Want them to know who we put, so let's put Coventry there, and then we'll do this like this, and then this one won't be much of a fight. In fact, he's going to run, assuming they don't have any. Oh, he can't run the first round of combat. That's right. And they do have an A, so let's see if Kent can kill him right off. He can. Was that the king? No, he's last in the line. Now we can regroup, although I don't think we will. All right, what a change of fortune for the Lancastrians. The board looks quite different now. We need to make sure we get someone in London. Okay, so 2-2, Lancastrians get to go again first. So do they want to press that battle here? Probably not. Is this where Bristol is? No, it isn't. I'm thinking about putting these two here. They'll probably come in and crush it. But if not, I have a feeling they're going to regroup there. In any case, what else can we do? That seems necessary. If they can reinforce with all their forces here. We can only get two across. So I think we're at a standstill as far as that goes. One movement left. We can't get London. All these nobles are going to go home. Hmm. Can we bring in the Bristol block to a neutral area? Or do we have to own it? Any friendly or vacant. So let's bring Bristol in. I don't think anyone's going to go there to deal with them. They have more pressing matters, so might as well. All right, that's R2. Now the last two for the Yorkists. We need to salvage our losses. So we're going to retreat back to here, I think. Seems reasonable. And then is there anything else to do? Is there any fights we want to pick? I think we want to pick this fight. Might as well, right? A1. No hits. A2. One hit. And then so many B2s. But we need to do them one at a time. We can't roll any loyalty checks, so that's going to be one hit. So he's done, he's done. York hasn't gone yet. Three dice for Hastings, no hits. And three dice for Suffolk, one hit. Two for York, they'll be retreating. So he will retreat. Back to here. He's not going to get the chance. One hit for this. And then I'm sure Norfolk will finish him off. Indeed he does. Let's check and see what happens with the churches. That gives us York. Good forward position. Okay, what happens to the churches when they die in combat?
Battles. Death. I think they're considered nobles. Other nobles and church. Aha. Go to the owner pool face down. Okay.
There's that. What happens to the levies? Right. They have him as well. Okay.
Very good. That's the year then, isn't it? I think it is. Okay, levies disband, levies, bombards, and Welsh return to the pools, mercenaries to their home areas. So mercenary. Okay, other side.
He's out. It did say levies, right? I'm pretty sure it did. Rebels get disbanded. He's out. Well, what happened to the Welsh?
I've already forgotten. They're out, I'm fairly certain.
They're just like mercenaries, right? Yeah. Well, there's no reason for me to put Bristol there, was there? Okay, I think that's fine then for everyone else. Rebels, mercenaries gone. So we do usurpation now. Each church box counts as one, occupation counts as a noble. So, not Scots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't think he counts. 7. One, two, three, four, five, six. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Might as well be infinity. That we are still king. Back around again. Alright. Pretender goes home. pretender and his heirs on map must go into exile. Only Somerset at a strength of one. Thank goodness he heals, but that is the last of the Lancastrian nobles. And he's fourth in line at that. Everyone else goes to their own shield and cathedral, but if enemy occupied, then return to the friendly pool. I could probably have skipped this and saved you guys from watching it, but what could be done? Where does he go? Uh-oh. Is that his only shield?
I think it is.
He's in the pool. Stanley. Buckingham. Ooh. Here, I think. That's fine. Back around again. And Castron's gonna have a tough go at it. I forget what happens to the king. I think he stays where he is. Put him in Oxford. Him here. Hastings. Kent. Do we want to put him all the way up there? Do we have an option? Do we have anything closer? Doesn't appear to be. Up there he goes. Alright, and then I think I'd remember to bring the rules with me to the other side of the table one of these times. Alright, the king. The king and royal heirs on map return to their shield or any crown area. Very good. Well, I think we'll bring them all to London. See no reason not to. And then everyone heals, right? And then that's it. All face down blocks in the pool stand up. Move the royal block to the pretender pool. All blocks raised to full strength. Shuffle, deal out cards, and then we are on the last campaign, ladies and gentlemen. So I've had to look a lot of rules up just because this is my first time going, but I can tell this is a much quicker game than Hammer the Scots. Some cards go quite quickly. I am enjoying the different decisions in this one than in Hammer the Scots, particularly in the combat. There seems to be a lot more options. So yeah, I'm going to upload this video, and then we'll get started on the third campaign.